This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to figure out how to get the trig functions for multiples of 30. All right, so we're going to figure this out by starting with an equilateral triangle. So an equilateral triangle, all the sides are the same length, and the angles are all the same, 60 degrees each. So let's say these are all the same length, and we could take any side we want, but I'm going to go ahead and say let's let all the sides be 2. Okay? I'm just going to put 2 and 2 there, although down here it's 2 also. There's a reason I haven't put this 60 degrees here yet. I'm going to drop a vertical line through here, so I'm going to make a 90 degree angle here. This is like the altitude of this triangle. So if I've done that, then I have split this angle of 60 degrees into 2, and there's how I can get 30 degrees. Right, so that's the reason I did that. And also, we know this bottom piece, the base here, has a length of 2, so it also splits that in 2 pieces, so this is 1 and this is 1. All right, so now what we're going to do is concentrate on one of these triangles, you see. How about I do this one over on the left? So let's just, that would be concentrating the one on the right. So let's just see if I had 60 degrees, 30 degrees, and that's 90 degrees. This is called a 30-60-90 triangle. Okay, you'll often hear it referred to that. So it has a 30 degree and a 60 degree, and then we have a 90 degree angle in it. And so if we look at this, remember this was 1 and this was 2. First thing I want you to notice is that the smallest leg has a side of 1 and the longest leg has a side of 2. It's twice as big. Okay, remember why that is? Because over here, if I had chosen 4, then this would be 2. If I had chosen 6, this little side would be 3. It ended up splitting it into 2 pieces. So the longest side, which is the hypotenuse, is twice as long as the shortest leg. And what we want to know is, how long is this piece right here? Okay, so let's use the Pythagorean Theorem. We're trying to find what that is. So we have 1 squared plus x squared equals 2 squared by the Pythagorean Theorem. So 1 squared plus x squared equals 2 squared, or 1 plus x squared equals 4. Subtracting 1 from both sides, I have x squared equals 3. And then we could just take the square root of both sides. And remember, x is a length, so x will be positive. So x is square root of 3. So in my picture here, this is now square root of 3. And this is the triangle you want to remember. Now, if you have any triangle, the smallest angle is across from the smallest side. So 30 degrees is the smallest angle, 1 is the smallest length of a side. 60 is the middle angle, right? It's between 30 and 90 degrees, and it's across from the medium side. Square root of 3 is between 1 and 2. And then the biggest angle is 90 degrees. It's across from the longest side of 2. So that's one thing you might remember. But basically, you want to get this triangle committed to memory. Okay? A 30-60-90 triangle, you can always write having a side, the smallest side of 1, the longest side or the hypotenuse of 2, and the medium side, square root of 3. Now, it doesn't have to be those values. It could really be some multiple of that. So in other words, if I multiplied all these numbers by 4, you could have a 4. 2 times 4 would be 8. Square root of 3 times 4 would be 4 square roots of 3. In other words, there's all the similar triangles. Anyway, now that we have this triangle, what I'm going to do is put it on the coordinate axes so that we can see what the trig values for either 30 degrees or 60 degrees is. So let's do that. All right, so on the right here is this triangle that we just figured out. This is one possible 30, 60, 90 triangle. And let's see, let's take if we want, let's first just do it for 60 degrees. What if I drew that angle over here, 60 degrees, it would go up like this. That's 60 degrees, right? And remember, we want to find some point on here. All right, so how about we make it so we draw this triangle right here. In other words, how about we say that would be, notice that's like going over one and up square, it's a three. If you want, you could sort of imagine that triangle right here where this is one and that's square to three, where that's the order pair one square to three. And then if that's the point we choose on that terminal side of the angle 60 degrees, because we're talking about 60 degrees here, then this has a length of 2, so that's my r. So that tells us that x equals 1, y equals square root of 3, and r equals 2, and now we're ready to do our trig functions. So let's see, let's do the cosine of 60 degrees. Well, that would be the x over the r, so it would be the 1 over the 2, right? Or I could look at my little picture here, the way I like to see the 1 over the 2. That means the reciprocal is going to be the secant. So the secant will just be 2. All right, how about the sine? The sine is 60 degrees. That will be the y value over the r, so that'll be square root of 3 over 2. So the cosecant would be the reciprocal. 2 over square root of 3, and if you rationalize that, you get 2 square root of 3 over 3. All right, how about the tangent? The tangent of 60 degrees is y over x, so that would be square root of 3 over 1, right? And square root of 3 over 1 is just square root of 3. And then the cotangent is the reciprocal, which is 1 over square root of 3, or if you rationalize it, square root of 3 over 3. So here's how to get the values for the cosine, the sine, the tangent, etc. for 60 degrees, and then similarly, you should also be able to do it for 30 degrees. So you might try that on your own, see if you could draw the picture for 30 degrees and see what you get. And then I'm going to do that one on the next video as well as some more problems using this 30, 60, 90 triangle. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.